Today I'm talking about Liz Frank injury. So firstly, we have to know what is that, Liz Frank. Liz Frank, it is a joint. It consists of many joints of the all metatarsal joints and also cuneiform and the cuboid. The cuneiform articulated with the three metatarsal, the first three metatarsal, and the cuboid articulated with the fourth and the fifth metatarsal. All of them, it serves that this joint is stable by many soft tissue. Soft tissue like a plantar abinerosis, long plantar abinerosis, and also here the pronaeus longus, which be inserted in the first, the medial border of the plantar surface of the metatarsal, and also with the anterior tibial tendons, all of them will support the Liz Frank joint. Also, the main stability of the Liz Frank is the shape of the mid cuneiform and also the cuboid and also all the first metatarsal. And it usually takes the what is called Roman arch, which is a wide from the dorsal surface, and also it is decreasing as a tapering or the wedge at the dorsum of the foot. So it gives more stability with this this reconstruct. And also there is what is called cuneiform mortise. Cuneiform mortise, which is a the second or keystone, is the second metatarsal, base of the metatarsal. And this is a cuneiform or cuneiform mortise. There is an insertion of the Liz Frank ligaments. So if we speaking about the Liz Frank, is the dislocation the most common injuries around the midfoot. And also about 20% of these injuries of log, especially in the polytraumatized patients, up to about 81 of injuries occur in multiple injuries patients. However, I would like to say that sometimes we found that a very dangerous injuries from Liz Frank, and also we found that subtle injuries. And this direct injuries, this with forces applied directly in transmetatarsal, as with the direct blows or industrial crush injuries. And also there is an often associated with severe soft tissue injuries, open around, and the risk of vascular may be compromised and compartmental syndrome. The mechanism of injuries with the direct, if the force coming to the first metatarsal and the, as a plantar displacement here, and also it, which it usually leading to about this is represent about 57% with the small fracture to the first metatarsal. Also, the dorsal displacement with the, and loading from the dorsum of the surface and also the plantar of the surface, leading to disruption and usually with the fracture or avulsion fracture here. Indirect fracture, the trauma, the foot or the ankle is a completely plant flexed and the toes is dorsiflexed, so it leading to dorsal displacement like this. And also indirect displacement, as we see that when the, there is an dorsiflexion may be leading to rupture of the metatarsal injury, like this, which is usually presented about 30%. Clinically, we require, firstly, require high degree of clinical suspicion, especially in the subtle cases, as sometimes become misdiagnosed. Is about 20% of this injuries is about misdiagnosed, and also about 40% no treatment in the first week, and the patient said that it is an little bit trauma, and so maybe there is no treatment. So midfoot sprain must be away from the diagnosis of Lisfranc injury. Clinically, sometimes it is usually in the midfoot, and also there is a swelling across the dorsum of the foot, and also there is a plantar ecchymosis. Deformity of course, plantar ecchymosis like this, but the deformity in the first time of injury, it is usually unusual, and also there is a local tenderness at the tarsometatarsal joint. Of course, odometers may be in the old foot, and poorly localized pain. Gentle stressing plantar dorsiflexion rotation will reveal instability. So we have to check also a neurovascular status, as also it is part of diagnosis or symptoms, and also it's a part of the complication, like the compartmental syndrome, which is a common in cases of Lisfranc injury. And also sometimes there may be deep peroneal nerve injuries or dorsal pedis artery also affection. So you have to check the dorsal pedis, and which is very important, and also deep peroneal nerve injury. To evaluate this this Lisfranc, if it is disrupted or injured or anything, I think it is better to do an firstly by plain X-ray. You have to do anterior view, lateral view, oblique view. As all of cases of foot in generally, we prefer that we do anterior lateral view with standing or in spine, but usually with standing it's better if the patient can do it. But if he couldn't, okay, it's no problems, but actually it is better to do an standing. As we see here, the different varieties from Lisfranc injuries. In anterior view, especially in the normal, in the standing view, the medial aspect of the first metatarsal, it is usually with the middle cuneiform, with the medial aspect in the same line. But if there is disturbance in these lines between the first, the second metatarsal with the medial aspect of the medial cuneiform, we see here there is about space about 1 millimeter. So you have to be suspicious that there is an affection of the Lisfranc ligaments or Lisfranc injuries will be occurred. In the second, in the lateral view, which is better, also in the standing, and the standing, the first and second metatarsal, it is usually in the same line and paired to each other in the lateral view here. But if there is any disturbance between them, between the first metatarsal and the medial cuneiform, the first, second metatarsal with medial cuneiform, so you have to suspicious that there is enough problem there. In oblique view, it is very important there. There are two sides here. The medial aspect of the fourth metatarsal, it is usually with the medial aspect of the cuboid here. And also the second metatarsal, lateral border of second metatarsal with the lateral border of the metatarsal of the medial cuneiform. So it is the same line here like this. So this is, and usually if there is any disturbance there, so it is suspicious for Lisfranc. There is another science, it's called the flake science, which usually occurs that it is an avulsion fracture. It's considered as avulsion fracture of the second, is the base of the second metatarsal. So this means that there is a problem. Another tool of that for evaluation is CT, which is play an important role, especially in looking for widening of the joint space, as we see here. Is the joint space between the this is medial cuneiform, is the base of the first metatarsal, and there is a fracture in the base of the second metatarsal. Also, it also can detect associated fracture and revealing, so for subluxation, it may be occurs. as also in the 3D, it's very important. I've also detect the occult fracture, or we can see also here the problem, there's a dislocation or subluxation of the second metatarsal from the mortise. Also, we can, in CT, it helped us to formulate the surgical treatment plan. MRI, it is usually play a role, or in cases with no obvious instability, identifying the partial ligaments injury, and also it can look looking for the less frank ligaments, which is there is tear or no tear. But actually, it does not play a role like CT scan. So the problems here, in the less frank ligament, it is an sulatory ligament, which it is usually extending from the base of the first the lateral border of the medial cuneiform to the medial border or the base of the second metatarsal. So it is very important to detect the problem. As this ligament injury, if there is injury for this ligament, it may, if even isolation will result a functional instability and the loss of longitudinal and transverse arches. So you're presented as high energy trauma, as we said that, like this, and subluxation, and like looks like that. So there are two classifications. The first classification is Nunley and Vitello in 2002 is about the ligaments, less frank ligaments itself, which stage one, it is a tear of the dorsal ligament of the or sprain of the less frank in stage one. Stage two, it is direct injury of the less frank ligament with elongation of the rupture, as we see here. So it is ruptured. If it is more, and we have to compare it to other leg, and it is, if it is more than 1 to 5 millimeter, it is greater than the contralateral foot. Stage three, it is the same as the stage two, but actually it was an avulsion fracture, as we said, that may be a fracture to the second metatarsal, the base of the second metatarsal. The most common classification for risk frank is introduced by Myerson classification, which is divided into three types. Type one is it is called with congruity, it's total incongruent, which it is maybe lateral or maybe dorsiplantar, and also partial incongruity like medial dislocation or lateral dislocation like type B1 and type B2. Type C is divert, it's a partial displacement, total displacement like type C2. But actually, this classification, it's usually, it is a little value and also fail to encompass all injurious types and do not useful in establishing the prognosis or to know that what is the prognosis. So it is simply that we have to put in our mind it in the is this fracture is entire the joint or not? Or is this disruption of the supportive ligaments, disruption of all supportive ligaments or not? Also, is there adequate resistance to the dorsal translation of the metatarsal? So early recognition is the key to preventing long-term disability. Also, anatomic reduction is necessary for best results, like displacement, if displacement more than 1 millimeter or growth instability, transmetatarsal, intercuneiform or navicular or joint unacceptable. So our goal of treatment is obtain or maintain the anatomic reduction, which is very important. In 2014, concluded in his publication about the Lisfranc fracture dislocation are the most common injuries around midfoot. And also it is usually required operative treatment. And they believe that operative treatment considerably improving the functional outcomes in this injury. However, if there is all injuries are displaced and unstable, surgical treatment is very important, and complete assessment of intercuneiform and cuboid integrity is very important to determining stability. And the clinical outcome is usually highly dependent on restoration of normal anatomical alignment. Also, the recommendation for treatment consists of open reduction of unstable area with rigid fixation with option in terms of the screw employed. Also, multiple K-wire have been advocated. In fact, screw fixation has been shown to provide a significantly greater biomechanical stability. However, there's a debate between the fixation and the method and the implant were used. In general, there are this is very important. The problems only in a stiff joint, which is represented by the first and second and the third tarsometatarsal joint. So it is better to rigid fixation, whatever, screws or plates or whatever. But the flexible joint, which it is represented by the fourth and the fifth, as all we know that we have two types of foot, or we have three columns, the medial column and the lateral column, the middle column. In general, the medial column, it is usually, it is not a movable, not like the lateral foot. So it is, and we said that it is a dynamic, the four, the middle, and static, the static foot, it is represented by the medial ray, and the lateral is called dynamic. Dynamic, so it is usually a movable joint. Which it is, this movable joint is a fourth and fifth tarsometatarsal joint. So it is usually need mobility. So it is better to, it fixes with the K-wire or whatever, but not rigid fixation or arthrodesis, which is very important. It's my opinion about in the middle ray, it is better to fix whatever plating or whatever. You do an arthrodesis or open reduction internal fixation, it is normal. But in lateral ray, it is better to do an reduction, but fix it with a K-wire, which after that, we can, after union or after the period of treatment, you can remove it and begin to move each joint. So the following is included in the patients in treatment or these options. Primary arthrodesis of the first and second, third metatarsal, cuneiform joints, metatarsal with the cuneiform joints, or suture button fixation, or dorsal bridge plating. However, this evidence, the evidence supporting the use of the technique is modest. Not all the primary or open reduction, not necessary to use the suture button fixation or dorsal bridge plating. However, in cases of plantar tarsometatarsal ligament intact, short leg cast is conservative treatment, which is very important, especially if the plantar tarsometatarsal ligament intact. If unstable in two planes due to fracture, the base of the in the at the base of the second or third metatarsal, we can fix with K-wire fixation. Unstable in two planes and with ligaments rupture, so rigid fixation or arthrodesis is very recommended. for non-displaced injury was normal weight bearing and x-ray, so short leg cast for 4 or 6 weeks and non-weight bearing at this period, and the repeated x-ray to rule out that displacement as a swelling. And total treatment usually in less frank, especially in conservative treatment, ranged from 2 to 3 months. Surgical emergencies, open fracture, if there is any vascular compromise, so we have to go. Also compartmental syndrome, which is also, it is an emergency to interfere or for open fracture to reduce. So open reduction and internal fixation, it is usually delay until excessive trauma, edema, of swelling has resolved, is the first. And second, be aware and ready to address all injuries present before beginning the surgical procedure. The patient is usually spine position and we're using a tourniquet, which is recommended. We have two approaches as if there is problems in the lateral and medial ray. One is the anteromedial and another is anterolateral. These two incisions for best complete visualization in the medial incision, line with the first web here, and the second incision of in the fourth in the fourth fourth metatarsal. In the first web, we open and we identified the dorsalis pedis and the peroneal nerve, and also we have to important to identify the extensor hallucis longus and the extensor hallucis brevis. As we said that here, this is an extensor the belly of the extensor hallucis brevis, and this is an extensor digitorum longus. Once the belly of the extensor hallucis brevis be open, so you have to going to dissect to in the lateral, and here the intermediate cuneiform or medial middle, and this is the medial cuneiform, and the base of favorite metatarsal, and this is the second metatarsal. It is an easy, you can go it. But the landmark for you is the extensor hallucis, the belly of extensor hallucis brevis here, in this one. The second incision, which is a small incision, as here, as open between the extensor digitorum longus and the extensor digitorum brevis, and we open and to see the cuboid here and the fourth metatarsal and the fifth metatarsal joint. So the first, as we see here, you open to the second metatarsal, here's the base, and after reduction, and you can reduce it. With the second or three incision if we need to go it. But with tarsal stabilization and joint inspected, anatomical reduction of the joint. You can also using what is called is home run screw, which is very important, especially in cases of the ligaments injuries or there is a ligament, this frank ligament injury. It is so easy, and also we can do in percutaneous, not a problem, as the cannulated screw is placed across the medial cuneiform at the base to the base of the second metatarsal, and also a screw going from medial cuneiform to intermediate or the middle cuneiform to reduce the Lisfranc diastasis. And also we're using this guide. And with this guide, you can do two options. You can reduce the second metatarsal and to be sure that you are going there. And also here, with the, this is an approach going to directly from the medial cuneiform to the base of the second metatarsal, as we see here. And the another screw is usually going to the from medial cuneiform to the middle or intermediate cuneiform here, as we see there. If you need more fixation, you can add it to the plating about if there is a problem there. So there is no tissue layers are present in this level. So window closure can be accomplished and with a non-absorbable suture to close the joint capsule and the non-absorbable suture also to close the skin. Post-operative, which is very important there, at well-budded posterior slab for immediately after procedure until swelling subside in 1-2 weeks. At this time, the splint can be converted to the non-width bearing short leg cast if the swelling is permanent. Embolization, the cast is usually maintained for about 3 months. The issues of how long the screw should remain, usually it is controversy. As if you need open reduction and internal fixation or using percutaneous there is an debatable part that the screw must be removed maybe after 6 months or 3 months. But actually, for me, if I need early movement and also I move after 3 months and the patient make an rehabilitation after removal of the cast, which is very important to allow the patient going early. Many complications usually occur in cases of left-frank injury, like as I said that foot compartmental. Sometimes the non-anatomic reduction or alignment. So problems, if there is left-frank problems and without anatomical reduction, here, as we say, we know that the tip posterior, it is usually inserted in the cuneiform. And if there is any disturbance there, it is will be loaded. So sometimes it leading to adult tip posterior dysfunction. So it leading to a more problematic and also maybe leading to deformities. Post-traumatic midfoot arthritis, which is a more common. Also painful hardware, failure of breakage, flat foot deformity, as I said, complex regional pain syndrome, it is usually occur, neuroma, infection, and the complication. The prognosis, it is usually to return to the normal activity or the normal work to him, maybe need a little bit 1 year about that, or maybe 10 months. Incomplete reduction lead to increase in instance of deformity and the chronic, of course, foot pain, loss of rigidity, especially in the lateral column, which is very important. So it is very painful. Instance of traumatic arthritis is usually intra-articular surface damage and comminution. So it may need to amputation. Maybe occur late collapse after the deformity. As I said that there is maybe leading to TPLS posterior dysfunction for this problem. So it is leading to collapse. So also we have in cases like severe injury, there are two options of treatment, is the open reduction and internal fixation or primary arthrodesis. As we said that, it is an also debatable part between them, as this is a series about trial of 41 patients and divided into group, primary ligaments injury, fused in the middle range, the first, second, third, and the other with the open reduction internal fixation. Recommended that or concluded that 5 patients of open reduction group went to arthrodesis. Another also publication about a trial of 32 patients both treated by primary arthrodesis. It's concluded that both primary arthrodesis and open reduction tendon fixation give and boost satisfaction satisfactory results. And but the cases of 20 to 12 from out of the 14 patients of open reduction need one arthrodesis and another need to remove the hardware. And sometimes the another arm said that no primary arthrodesis, better to do an open reduction internal fixation. And also the same two groups, open reduction and internal fixation, and about 12 in open reduction and internal fixation, with the arthrodesis. In this case, said that there is a higher pain in arthrodesis group. So actually, you can see what is better for the patient. If the patient is unstable, it's better to do an arthrodesis. Your aim is reduce the mechanics of the foot, which is very important. Maintain the arch of the foot, maintain all mechanics. So whatever this is achieved by reduction, open reduction with internal fixation, or achieved by arthrodesis, you have to achieve that. Stable, anatomical, or useful mechanical foot. So complication, higher and complete arthrodesis, it is an debatable part there. But actually, you can determine what you need, especially intraoperative. For conclusion, for all injuries that are displaced, unstable, surgical treatment is required, complete assessment, intercuneiform and cuboid integrity is important to determine stability. The clinical outcome is highly dependent in the restoration of normal anatomic ligaments. Thank you. I hope that will be good. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Professor Hani Mwafi, for this very, very interesting talk. Shukran jazeera, Ustazna Habib al-Fadl. هاني بيه معانا دكتور محمود سامع حضرتك مودريتور مع دكتور هاني
تمام يا فندم ويتنج فور اني كويشن
انا بسمعك كويس دكتور محمود في مشكلة في الصوت
هو في مشكلة في الصوت بس هو تقريبا
هو غالبا عند دكتور وائل بيه في تشويش حاجة في الصوت عند دكتور وائل بيه حضرتك سامعني؟ هو غالبا التشويش ده معاه سعادتك عشان كده حضرتك بتشيك يا فندم عن سعادتك الصوت يعني حضرتك بتسالني عليه. تمام. اتفضل يا دكتور محمود.
هو بس لسه الصوت مش واضح.
هو كان واضح في المحاضره يا محمود؟
لا كان واضح يا فندم. لا كان كويس جدا.
طب كويس.
البيت ممكن سعادتك تعمل ميوت كده صوت من عند دكتور وائل
تمام
طيب دكتور وائل بيه
كلمه الموبايل احسن
ما هو انا اكلمه الموبايل هي غالبا الهيدفون بتاع الايرفون بتاع الدكتور وائل دكتور وائل بيه غالبا حضرتك دي الهيدفون يا فندم عند حضرتك كده التشويش اختفى كده اختفى
تمام شكرا لحضرتك يا دكتور هاني على المحاضره الرائعه وبنستاذن حضرتك نبدا بس بعض الاسئله يعني هو في حد بيسال حضرتك يا فندم هو بالنسبه للحالات اللي فيها بيور ليجامنتس ليس فرانكي انجري وهو عمل ريدكشن وحط كي ويرز بيسال حضرتك عن الوقت اللي هو ممكن يشيل فيه الكي ويرز والعيان يرجع للديلي اكتيفيتيز بتاعته
هو بس لو فيها ليجمنتس انشري للليس فرانك بس الكواير ام نوت ريكومند الكواير which is better to do in screws which is very important. كواير بالنسبه لها ممكن يبقى في مشكله معانا, ممكن يحصل فيه سبلكسيشن, ممكن يحصل فيه اي حاجه, which is better ان احنا نعمل كومبريشن سكرو which is very important. لا تستغرق قد ايه؟ هو احنا اتفقنا ان هو مبدئيا ان احنا بنحطه الاول في يعني في سبلنت, وبعدين بعد كده بنستنى لغايه يعني شهر ونص نبتدي نعمل بارشال ويت بيرنج موفمنت, لكن ما بنعملش كومبليت ويت بيرنج الا بعد 3 اشهر نفس. وانت ديبندس برضو على اللي انت شايفه. لو انت برضو من بالنسبه لي لو انت مثلا عامل جاست سكرو وانت شايف ان الدنيا كويسه وبعد 3 اشهر بتشيل السكرو ده بمنتهى البساطه, برضو بيركوتينس بالمناسبه لو هي ليجامنتس انجري بس.
تمام. هو السؤال الثاني بيسال حضرتك, هل في بالنسبه للحالات اللي بيور ليجامنتس برضه هو في فرصه ان هو يعمل كلوزد ريدكشن وبيركوتينيوس بيننج من غير ما يعمل اوبن سيرجري؟ يعني
هو بيركوتينيوس بيننج لل يعني خلينا نتفق يا جماعه, اي حاجه في الميديا راي which is better, بلاش اللي هو الكي وايرز لكن it's better ان احنا نعمل سكرو which very important عشان to get stability, لان الليس فرانك عموما الجوينت نفسه هو احنا قلنا وانا بتكلم بقول ان هو لو في حصل فيه تير sometimes بيحصل avulsion fracture, يبقى ده بيأفكت على كل ال بيأفكت على كل الهدم اللي موجوده او بيأفكت على الهدم بتاعت الجوينت. سمعني محمود؟
ايوه يا فندم سامعين حضرتك, بس هو التشويش راجع تاني.
طيب اوكي ده اللي انا عاوز اقوله. فبالتالي اتس بيتر ان احنا نثبتها صح عشان ما يحصلش بروبلمز معانا بعد كده, ما يحصلناش ديفورميتي زي ما قلت ان هو الام بتاعنا في دي ان احنا بنعمل لازم نرجعها اناتوميكال عشان ما نعملش ستريسز على التيب بوستيريور which is very important في الموضوع ده. Sometimes ممكن تعمل لي بتعمل dysfunction للتبال البستيريور لو ما رجعتش anatomical, ممكن بيظهر بعد كده يحصل فيه flat foot او يحصل لها deformity بعد كده. فإتس بيتر نحط الواير. طبعا بيركتينس انا شخصيا بحبها بس وبنعملها حتى باللي هو بالفورس ده بنعمل reduction وبعدين بعد كده بندخل الواير في الميديال كينوفورم, قصدي بندخل الجايد واير بتاعنا بنحط بعد كده نحط اللي هو الكانيولات سكرو عليها وبنعمل كومبريشن سواء في من الميديال كينوفورم للسكند ميتارسل ولا الميديال كينوفورم للميدل كينوفورم.
تمام يا فندم. احنا كنا عايزين نسال حضرتك بس عن ان حضرتك البروتوكول بتاع حضرتك في حالات البيور ليجامنتس ليس فرانك انجري بيرسونال, يعني حضرتك بتفضل تعمل اكيوت اوفر ريدكشن وانترنال فيكسيشن ولا بتعمل برايمري ارثروديزيس؟
لا في لا لو كان في ليجامنتس انجري بس لا نعمل بعمل اوفر ريدكشن. بالعكس انا لو في بس بيور ليجامنتس انجري بعمل حتى بيركوتينس سكروز ودي بالنسبه لي بعمل, لكن لو كان فيها دايفرجن فيها مشكله بنعمل open reduction وبثبت برضو زي ما اتفقنا بثبت اللي هو الميديال ري كله بس بعمل له open reduction وبحط screw for 3 months وبشيله لو الarticular surface مش affected, لكن لو الarticular surface affected من الأول بعمل arthrodesis. الثيرد قصدي الفورث ميتارسل مع والفيفث ميتارسل مع حالات الكيوبويد بريدوس وبحط كي وايرز that's enough to maintain لها, وفي نفس الوقت اوكي دي هترجع بس اهم حاجه ان احنا to get stability ان احنا بنرجع less rank ligaments نفسه which is very important لها.
تمام. طيب حاجة بالنسبه للحالات اللي هي neglected less rank سواء بوني او pure ligamentous less rank وneglected, حضرتك يعني ال extension of arthrodesis اللي حضرتك تحب تعمله, يعني تعمل حاجة first و second و third ترسل متترسل ولا حاجة بت extend posteriorly proximally لحد ال navicular؟
هقول لك على حاجة. هي بص، أنا إمتى بمد للنافيكلر؟ لو كان حصل فيه تب ستيريوس فانكشن، يعني لو كان حصل ديفورمتي، فبمد لغاية النافيكلر. يعني دي لازم أثبتهم، لأن عشان أنا ريستورنج الأرش تاني وأرجعه، استحالة يعني هبقى هلود وهيفيل مني لو أنا ما ثبتش النافيكلر، لأن التب ستيريور حصل لها مشكلة وهي مش هتقدر تشيل الارش نفسه او هتقدر ترفع لي الارش نفسه. فانا باكستند لغايه النافيكلر وبعمل ده، وبعدين بعد كده برضو باسس لو في مثلا في بروبلمز انتر ارتيكل فراكشر مثلا في السكند او الثيرد ميتارسال، بحط اللي هو ممكن احط اللي هو البليتنج او لهم دول، ودول بيبقوا ارثروديز. لو نجلكتد بعمل ارثروديز اوتوماتيكالي وات ايفر شكل الموضوع ايه، ما عدا في الفورث والفيفث مترسل، لا بحاول ان انا بريزيرف، واحاول ان انا ايفن حتى لو كان فيهم سنه يعني فيها في ان هم كانوا بروبلماتيك، ان انا بحاول ان انا افتر ريدكشن للميديال ري، برجع تاني واطمن اشوف الدنيا شكلها ازاي، وممكن اعمل جاست ستابيليتي بكي وايرز لو. لكن في حالات الليس فرانك اللي هي نجلكتد، بس اللي هي سكند مش انجر، هي انجر نتيجه ان في شاركو، لا انا بثبت الميديال راي واللاترال راي، حتى بحط ممكن احط انتر ميدالر سكرو اللي هو الدبل كومبريشن سكرو على اللاترال من لغايه الفيفث مترسل من الكالكينيوس للكيوبويد لده، وبرده الميديال راي برده ممكن اثبتهم بليتنج او اللي هو دايابيتك بليت او كلام من ده، بس في ده بس في حالات الشاركو. لكن في الانجرز العادي لا
تروماتيك،
لا ما لاترال كولوم لازم اخلي بالي منه واحافظ عليه وبرزيرف الجوينت از ماتش از يو كان.
تمام يا فندم، شكرا جزيلا لوقت حضرتك وعلى المعلومات الرائعه اللي استفدنا حضرتك منها يا فندم، كتر خير
شكرا
حضرتك.
شكرا جزيلا استاذنا الفاضل استاذ دكتور هاني بيه موافي على المحاضره الرائعه وعلى الوقت اللي حضرتك قضيته معانا النهارده يا فندم،
الله
شرف
يخليك.
كبير لنا دكتور هاني بيه.
انا بس تأذنوا لي ان انا ابقى معاكم عشان اسمع برضه استمتع
يا فندم
بالدكتور
احنا
وائل
نتشرف، احنا
واستمتع
نتشرف يا
واتعلم
دكتور هاني
منه،
بيه.
لان الدكتور وائل دايما محاضراته جميله، وانا بحب بصراحه بعد اذنك يا دكتور وائل يعني ممكن
شرف ليه يا فندم طبعا،
الله يخليك، شرف ليه انا حبيبي، ما تحرمش
دكتور
منك
وائل بيه انا هستأذن سعادتك.